Look in your kitchen cupboard or just at the general products around your house and you will most likely find barcodes all over those products. We are pretty used to them, the most common usage of them being for when we are shopping so products can quickly be scanned instead of them manually having to be entered into POS systems. So how does this seemingly simple technology work and how are the white and black bars converted into numbers? Depending on where you live depends on the sort of barcode you will see on the back of your products. There are two main types of barcodes, UPC and EAN. UPC is far more common in the United States, whereas EAN is far more common everywhere else in the world, but pretty much any scanner can read both types. On products which use the EAN type of barcode, the EAN13 format is the most common. This 13-digit long number is made up of four parts: a 3-digit GS1 prefix, a manufacturer code, a product code, and then a check digit. Examples of GS1 prefixes are the following numbers for the United States, France, Germany, Japan, Australia, and New Zealand. These numbers help show you the GS1 member organization which the manufacturer has joined, but doesn't necessarily mean it's actually made there. As you can see, this Rizzoni has a GS1 prefix from Italy, these tacos to Spain, this Vegemite to Australia, and these chips to New Zealand. The next part in the barcode is the manufacturer code, which has a variable length. It is variable on the basis that if you have a manufacturer code of 5 digits, you could have up to 99,999 product codes, which would be a waste on smaller companies who may only produce a handful of products, meaning they get longer manufacturer codes, therefore meaning the number of product codes they can have is less. After the manufacturing code and the product code is the check digit, which is calculated using modular arithmetic and helps to verify that the information on the barcode has been read correctly. The way in which EAN13 codes turn into actual barcodes is not exactly straightforward. The numbers are split up into three groups: the first digit, the first group of six, and the last group of six. The first six digits can be encoded two ways, as even or odd parities, denoted as G and L digits. The last six digits are always encoded as R digits. Based on what the first number of the code is, depends on how the first six digits will be encoded. You can see this here, with the L and G referring to how the number should be encoded into white and black bars, based on what the first digit of the code is. For example, here is how you would encode the following number. First, as the first number is 8, you would use the 8th structure for the first and last group of six digits. So the 7 would be from the 7L digits, the 1 would be the 1 from the G digits, the other one would be the one from the L digits, the 2 would be the 2 from the G digits, the 5 would be the 5 from the G digits, and the 3 would be the 3 from the L digits. Then for the remaining 6 numbers, they would be their numbers in the R digits. To keep things fun and interesting, the R digits are bitwise complements of their respective entries in the L column, and the G column entries are the R column in reverse bit order. In simpler terms, this means that what is white in the L digits encoding of a number is black in the R digits encoding, and what is black in the L digits encoding of a number is white in the R digits encoding of a number. And then with the R and G encodings, you can see that they're just mirrored. You may have noticed on smaller products that they often have smaller barcodes. These are called EN8 barcodes and consist of 8 numbers, with the first 2 to 3 digits being the GS1 code, as mentioned earlier, and the following 4 to 5 numbers being an item reference number, followed by a checksum digit. When it comes to converting the numbers to black and white bars, it is much simpler, with the first 4 numbers being encoded as L digits and the last 4 being encoded as R digits, meaning it doesn't follow the L and G digit encoding which EN13 uses. There are many other sorts of barcodes used in all sorts of different scenarios, but these are the most popular ones you will find on your store-bought products. Thank you for watching and be sure to subscribe.